Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, I am Varadhan. I share interesting stories and concepts from the books and articles I read.
Are you unable to manage your finance? Planning to learn more about your personal investments? Just invest in SIP and do nothing about your finance, whereas working hard to ensure your employer profit grows? Planning to buy things in an EMI without thinking for a moment? Here is the solution for you. We are going to see an interesting book, which is Amazon's best-selling books in investing basics, The Psychology of Money by Morgan Housel. I would like to thank my friend Makrin for asking me to present this book. Morgan worked as a valet at a nice hotel in Los Angeles in his college days. One frequent guest was a technology executive having designed and patented a key component in Wi-Fi. He had started and sold several companies. He was wildly successful. He bragged openly about his wealth. One of the days, he asked Morgan's colleague to buy $1,000 worth gold coins from the nearby jewelry store. An hour later, the executive and his friends gathered in a dock overlooking the Pacific Ocean and started to throw the gold coins into the sea to see whose coins went further. On another day, he broke a $500 lamp in the hotel. When the manager asked to pay, he handed over $5,000 and asked the manager to get out from his sight and never insult him again. After a few years later, he went broke. Doing well with the money has little to do with how smart you are and a lot to do with how you behave. And the behavior is hard to teach, even to brilliant people. Ordinary folks with no financial education can be wealthy if they have a handful of behavioral skills that have nothing to do with the formal measure of intelligence.
Ronald Reed was an American philanthropist, investor, janitor, and gas station attendant. That's how his Wikipedia mentions about him. Ronald was a mechanic at the petrol pump for 25 years and a cleaner at JCPenney's for 17 years. He bought a two-bedroom house for $12,000 when he was 38, which he lived in for the rest of his life. His main hobby was chopping firewood. In his will, Ronald left $2 million to his stepkids and more than $6 million to his local hospital and library. Where did he get all that money from? It turns out, Ronald saved what little he could and invested it into blue chip stocks. Then he waited and waited. Finally, his tiny savings compounded into more than $8 million.
A few months before Ronald Reed died, another man named Richard was in the news. Richard was everything Ronald was not. He was Merrill Lynch executive who graduated from Harvard. He had a successful career in finance, so successful in fact that he retired in his 40s. In the mid-2000s, Richard borrowed heavily to expand his $18,000 square foot room, which had 11 bathrooms, 2 elevators, 2 pools, 7 garages and cost $90,000 per month to maintain. Then came the 2008 global financial crisis. Everything fell apart. The crisis turned Richard's finance into dust. High debt and illiquid assets bankrupted him. All it took was a black swan event to eclipse the education and experience gap between the Richard and Ronald. Investing is not a game where the guy with the 160 IQ beats the guy with the 130 IQ. Once you have ordinary intelligence, what you need is a temperament to control the urges that get other people into trouble in investing. Financial success is not hard science, it is a soft skill, where how you behave is more important than what you know. We think and our thought about money is too much like physics, where there are rules and laws and not enough like psychology with emotions and nuances. Finance is guided by the people's behavior, and how I behave might make sense to me but look crazy to you. People don't bury themselves in debt because of interest rates. They do so because of greed, insecurity and optimism. Investors don't sell out of the bottom of a bear market because of expected future returns. they do so because they think about the agony of going to their spouse and telling them that investment may affect their future. Imagine a worst case scenario. Ask yourself, what misguided action led to this sorry fate? And then avoid that self-destructive behavior. History never repeat himself. Man always does. It applies so well how we behave with money. In this book, Morgan presents 20 stories to convey that soft skills are more important than the technical side of money.
If you like this video, please share it with your friends and family members. We'll meet you next week with one more interesting topic. Till then, it's goodbye.